Today we have to discuss about the topic is massive osteolysis in disease of bones and joints. Massive osteolysis is otherwise known as vanishing bone, disappearing bone, phantom bone, progressive osteolysis, Gorgon-Stout syndrome. Because in these cases, the massive osteolysis, particularly especially in jaw, it is the massive osteoclastic activity, particularly one area like jaw. This is leads to total disappearance of the bone in the particular area. Like it is a very progressive, say, because it is due to that vascular endothelial cells, which is especially the lymphatic vessels, stimulate the osteoclastic activity, leads to bone destructions that leads to total disappearance of the bone. How this happen? Because this lymphatic endothelial cells stimulate that MCSF in the Rankl. This role is stimulate the precursor osteoclast. That precursor osteoclast grouped together to form a osteoclast. In this precursor osteoclast or osteoclast synthesis, that platelet derived growth factor. This platelet derived growth factor stimulate lymphatic endothelial cells. This is one cycle, like a cycle mechanism. In case if MCSF or Rankl is controlled by some kind of proteins that are inhibited or blocked, these two highly stimulation of precursor osteoclast, or otherwise this precursor osteoclast was sensitive to those MCSF or Rankl, or the precursor osteoclast highly synthesis the PDF platelet derived growth factor because of this precursor osteoclast. This is very sensitive. At the same time, this is unknown etiology, because this also sometimes this also cause due to increase in MCSF. Sometimes it is very sensitive. It is unknown etiology. It is still unknown who, what is the main reasons to stimulate that those osteoclastic activity. But or approximately we have to say this is due to lymphatic endothelial cells stimulate the precursor osteoclast that lead to complete bone destructions. In these clinical features, it almost occurs that most of the all age group of peoples, but most commonly seen in below 40 years of age. This also includes that bones are maxillofacial regions and upper extremities, and leads to pathological fractures. Bone pain and swelling with functional impairment also seen in these cases. This complication is bone infection and septic shock. The bone infection is due to like any caries or extraction that lead to the bone, the jawbone get infected, or that extraction are done by the bacterial accumulation in those area, that leads to form a septic shock. The septic shock, what is the septic shock? The septic shock is due to the bacterial infections that produce a toxin. The toxin leads to that septic shock. The septic shock also caused the blood investigations. The slightly elevated serum alkaline phosphate are also seen. Why these slightly elevated serum alkaline phosphate seen in the blood? Because this, wherever the osteoclastic activity is done, the breakdown of the calcium and the phosphorus, so the phosphorus content is high in the blood, blood. So we have to see the alkaline phosphate elevated serum, elevated alkaline phosphate. In these radiographic features, it is also on the subcortical area and medullary cavities is very radial lucency, intramedullary subcortical area especially. Histological features, it is lytic changes in the bone. This is surrounded by a small highly vascularized cells, like this one vascular, this one vascular, this one vascular. Highly vascularized cells, it is surrounded by the endothelial cells. Numerous multinucleated osteoclastic also seen. This like the numerous multinucleated osteoclast seen. What is osteoclast basically formed by the precursor osteoclasts are grouped together to form a osteoclast. These are precursor osteoclasts. These precursor osteoclasts are grouped together to form a osteoclast. So these osteoclasts are multinucleated. There is no treatment. In fact, we have to give bisphosphonate to stop the osteoclastic activity. For vitamin D helps to absorption of calcium. Calcium helps to build up the bone matrices. Interferon alpha 2b help to block the platelet derived growth factor receptors, and androgen helps to stimulate the osteoblastic and maintain the bone matrices. In recent research about that, in order to block that receptor of lymphangiogenesis, especially platelet derived growth factor pathway.